The latest version of Pages, version 7.1, has a new feature that allows you to add a background in page layout documents. So let's take a look. I'm going to choose a basic template here and I'm going to convert that to a page layout document. As a standard word processing document, this feature isn't available. That's when you have text flowing from one page to the next. But page layout documents that you use to create things like signs and brochures, that's where this feature is. Now you want to make sure format is selected here on the right sidebar, and you can see here that there's a section for background. If it's closed, you want to open it by clicking here. So let's zoom out actually so we can see the whole page here. Something like that would be great. Now we can fill it with a color. So I could change to color fill and you could see it does a solid color here. I can choose from one of these chips here. I can choose from here or click here to bring up the color selector. I'll choose any color I want. So color fill is pretty basic. Gradient fill gets a little more complex as it's going from one color to another. So you can see I can have it go left to right or up and down, change the angle manually here. I can change what color it goes from and what color it goes to. For more complex settings, go to Advanced Gradient Fill. And now I can actually, you know, have more one color than another, change the midpoint between colors, add another color in there so I can have multiple colors. So I can create pretty advanced things. And I can also go to a Radial Fill here. You can reverse it, you can change the angle, lots of things that you can do in Advanced Gradient Fill. Image Fill is where you take some image, could be a photograph, could be a texture, whatever. It's got this here by default and you can choose to you know, have it displayed either tiled, scale the whole thing to fill, scale to fit. If tiled, you can change the size so you can zoom in or out. And let's say we want to use our own. You can just drag and drop. I'm going to drag an image, a file from the Finder, drag it into here. And you can see it put it there. And now I can, let's see, if I scale to fill it, that's what it looks like. Fit, you can now see the entire thing. If I tile it, you can see there it is tiled. And you can zoom in and out. So that's really useful to be able to do it like that. You can do an advanced image fill. And the interesting thing about advanced image fill is you're using the same image, but now you can actually colorize it. So I can change the color, the tint of what I'm using, which in this case works out really well. So here's another one I've got, another image. It's like a water image there. And I can, you know, change it to a different color to do something different with it. So these are really useful. Obviously these are probably not going to be used for things that you print out, because you can imagine the amount of ink you're going to use when you're printing this out, even on a good efficient, you know, laser printer or something. But now that we create things like PDFs and all, with Pages mostly, you can use this to make some interesting backgrounds. And of course if you're just doing a one-off sign or something like that and you have a good color printer, then using a background could be an interesting way to make it stand out.